1930s commissioned a very special project. And it was to celebrate, it was a concert to celebrate the cultural ranges that immigration brings here to us in the UK. It also highlighted some of the difficulties of the journey here and the challenge of making a life here. The project is called the Passerine, which means a collection of songbirds, migratory and indigenous, who come together to sing. Now, there are 9 countries that these people come from, and each one of them comes as a refugee or is affiliated with that situation. And as this is a Shrewsbury Folk Festival, whole big organization to get this going, then this is their very first performance. So as this was commissioned by Shrewsbury, this is the first one, and we are absolutely delighted. They are led by 2 familiar faces in the folk scene, the very talented Belinda O'Hooley and Heidi Tidow. So please give the warmest, most wonderful welcome to these great people, the Passerine.
Y'all all right? It's absolutely amazing to be here. We are so delighted to bring this project for the first time to Shrewsbury Folk Festival. My name is Heidi Tidow. I'm one half of O'Hooley Tidow. Has anybody seen us before? Yeah. Woo. Anybody not seen us before? Yeah. About equal. That's a good start. Well, when me and Belinda came off stage at Wickham Festival last summer, there was a woman there who came up to us after called Joy Lamont. And she works at Shrewsbury. Joy Lamont. She's from Shrewsbury Folk Festival. And she said, "Girls, I love your song, Made in England." She said, "I've got an idea and I want you to be involved in it." So Belinda O'Hooley on my right here is going to tell you about the song.
Hello, Shrewsbury. It's great to be here. A few years ago, we seemed to be getting a leaflet every other week from an organisation, I don't know if you've heard of them, the BNP? Ooh. I think they've changed their name now to the DUP. And in the leaflet, it was always about immigration. Immigration is the problem. We need to close the borders between Shrewsbury and Hereford, and we thought, we're not having that. We're going to write a song about it, because the same people that were saying that were bobbing off to our local curry house for a biryani.
Or maybe a kebab.
Washing it down with European lager. Oh, the irony. So we wrote a song, and we're going to perform it for you now. It's called Made in England.
Made in England, England, England. Made in England, England.
A song for you and everyone that inhabit dear old Albion, a coastal waters heaving ho, as waves of travellers come and go.
Who decide to guard the rights? The ballad of Britain begins tonight. Turning left on the Horan Leeds, children spilling across the streets, football chanting undulates, searching for Anglo-Saxon ways.
White admirals won't amalgamate, for Cora and Pint, ironically great.
With a roomy curry kebab in a hurry, bags and becks from the corner shop, head to toe in pride and mug. I'm made in England, 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 made in England.
climb the bottom rung we must exploit. Whilst weary workers worn out by debt don't know who to vote for next. From Rumi via Bangladesh, the hunger for cheap, it never rests. Pile 'em high and sell 'em cheap. The gentle sigh as foundations creak. Wait, make room before a bomb in a hurry. Facts and bags from the corner shop. Head to toe in pride and mark. I'm made in England, England, England. Made in England, England. I'm made in England, England, England.
To be part of this amazing band, the Passerine, and we are a collective of refugees, migrants, and people that come from migrant families, including me and Heidi. But above all, we are all people. We are all people. And what makes it okay for some people to come into this country and others not? Because let's face it, we're all a bit of a mishmash. I mean, I'm half Irish, quarter Welsh, and wait for it, quarter Liverpudlian.
Get out.
And what about you, Hyde?
Well, it doesn't look much better for me, because I'm half German, nearly half Irish, and a little bit Yorkshire.
Get out.
I'll get me coat.
There are some incredible stories today that we're going to try and share with you. We can't share all of them, but to help us do that, we have got a fantastic narrator, presenter, and spoken word performer, all rolled into one fabulous chap. And we're going to welcome him now.
Yes, he's one of the UK's finest poets. He's been described as the Gil Scott Heron of our generation. Would you please give a massive Shrewsbury Folk Festival welcome to the wonderful Dean Atta.
Hello, Shrewsbury. It's lovely to be here for the first time. So my job is to give these two a break from talking and tell you about all the songs and all the wonderful performers you have before you. So the next song is called Journey of the Unbelonging and is written by Mina Salama. Mina is from Egypt and is a multi-instrumentalist. He previously worked as the maestro assistant, composer, and arranger at the Egyptian Opera House in Alexandria before he left Egypt and came to live in Britain. I think we can see a picture of Mina looking rather dashing whilst working with the orchestra in Egypt. This composition is part of a musical conversation with our percussionist, Arian Sadr, who is from Iran. Journey of the Unbelonging tells the story of the terrible trek that many refugees have to make to reach some sort of sanctuary, undertaking difficult and often dangerous journey over land and sea, but somehow trying to keep the hope in your heart alive that someday, somewhere, you will find refuge. The song is sung in Egyptian Arabic slang, and I am going to try and give you a rough translation of the words during the performance. So this is Journey of the Unbelonging. Our next song is by Sarah Yaseen. Sarah is a Sufi singer-songwriter from Manchester and of Pakistani heritage. Born and raised in England, Sarah wanted to move to London and study in the textile industry. But instead, at the age of 19, she was sent to Pakistan to a small village where it had been arranged for Sarah to be married to a young man she'd never met before. And we have a picture of Sarah on her wedding day. Supposedly the happiest day of your life, but as you can see, it wasn't for Sarah. This song is Sarah's tribute to women of her own generation who went through the same unwanted journey, to offer a chance to think differently for the next generation and be an example of courage, for freedom for future generations. This is I Am Mine.
Not mine.
Okay. Before the next song, I'm going to read a poem that I wrote inspired by a very moving conversation I had with the next member of the Passerine I'll be introducing you to shortly. We spoke about her experience in Middlesbrough, where over 100 refugees had their front doors painted red by the company responsible for the maintenance of their properties. This poem is called Red Doors for Refugees. They know why you're here now, if they didn't before. Everyone is talking about your red door. They ask your child in the playground, what color is your door? If it's red, we can't play with you anymore. No red carpet, though you were VIP before. All the attention is placed on your red door. Eggs thrown at your window, ketchup on the floor, through the letterbox of your red door. You came here seeking asylum, but had more cruelty to endure. Your home was made a target by your red door. A national news story, Middlesbrough's shame forevermore. You can't paint over the pain of living behind a red door. Thank you. And thank you to Shurooq for sharing that story with me to write that poem. So our next song is co-written and sung by Shurooq Abounnass, who is from Sudan. Shurooq is a huge recording star and with hit records and numerous TV appearances. And Shurooq told us today that in Sudan, four national newspapers have run a story saying she's playing at Shrewsbury Folk Festival.
Hi, everybody.
And so she's put the link on her website for her fans so they can watch the show. So we can say hello to all the people watching via the web in Sudan. Hello, Sudan.
Hello, Sudan.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm Shurooq Abounnass from Sudan. And my song, Karabisha, is talking about welcoming strangers. In Sudan, we will say, Itfaddal, it means welcome. And this hospitality, it's central of our culture. And that what you used to grow in, just welcome the strangers. And I would love you all to join me and to feel my feelings, because this song really talking about my story. I would love you if you join me at the end of the song. I'll be very happy. Thank you so much. Thanks.
Thank you.
Shurooq and Elnaas.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Wow. Being a part of this project has been such an emotional journey and roller coaster for both me and Belinda, and of course the rest of the band. Thank you so much for sharing today with us. Now we're going to sing you a song that Belinda and I wrote a few years ago. And we thought it really fitted into this set, because migration has happened throughout history. People have moved between continents, between countries, all the way throughout history. And this song was inspired by a film we watched called Oranges and Sunshine a few years ago by Jim Loach. And it was about the controversial child migration scheme where children were shipped away right up until the 1970s on boats to other lands, Australia, New Zealand, Canada. Many of them were orphans, they were poor, many of them from single parent families. They were sent without parents, without guardians, not knowing where they were going or what was going to happen to them when they got there. They were promised oranges and sunshine, but what often happened was that they were placed into institutions and many of them treated really cruelly. Many of them didn't see their siblings or any of their families again. We really wanted to sing this song today. It's a song called Two Mothers. And the song really can be thought of as an allegory that the two mothers represent the two countries which many migrants find themselves caught between, including myself. And this song also introduces our wonderful Vijay Venkat from India, who will be playing the flute on this song. This is Two Mothers.
To a world turned around, new heights.
like the tide, she ebbs and flows, and in my arms I cradle a child of my own. Her eyes, the forest green, whilst mine a cornflower blue. Perhaps they're a keepsake from you.
Our next featured singer is Avital Raz. Avi is from Jerusalem, where she studied vocal performance and classical composition before moving to India for 6 years to study the ancient art of Drupad singing. She now lives in Sheffield, where she teaches singing and Indian classical music. She has a number of albums in her own right, and this song is originally from her album, The Believer. It's a feminist anthem. Any feminist in the house?
Yay!
Thought so. And it reflects attitudes to women in some cultures. It's called In the Garden.
Avital, this one is playing this beautiful instrument here, a tempura.
We asked her if she could do this because she's playing tempura and glockenspiel and singing. We asked her if she could do it on a unicycle.
She said no.
Thank you.
so deliciously.
Avital Raz.
When I was invited to be part of this project, Belinda and Heidi specifically wanted me to perform this poem. It's about not being taught your mother tongue. For me, that was Greek, and about how not knowing that language can make you feel like a stranger in your family. So this poem is called Mother Tongue. Our mother has swallowed her tongue. Though selfish is never a word we would call mum, I feel she has been so by swallowing her tongue. To make it worse, our family holidays are always to her motherland. She forgets to translate, even though she knows we don't understand. My sister and I make do and get by on the meaning we can infer from gestures and inflection. Can never look to mum for direction. Mother has swallowed her tongue, shows no regrets on reflection, stubborn. She refuses to see that she has wronged us not to teach, to give us the option, the basic right of freedom of speech with our grandparents, our aunts, uncles, and our cousins. There are a few shortcuts to understanding. Common language is a good paving stone. So when you can't speak the language of love, you realize you may be walking this path alone. Made in England, we're half this and half that, but they could more easily overlook that fact if we could speak with our mother's tongue. Not let our skin speak for us, but join in the family chorus. I can't tell you why she would willfully deny her daughter and her son, but she has swallowed it, and we are struck dumb. Our mother has swallowed her tongue. Okay, thank you. Now, another song led by Belinda and Heidi. As we said earlier, Belinda and Heidi are from Irish backgrounds. Their families came to Britain to escape the Irish potato famines and to find work. At the time, there was plenty of jobs for Irish migrants picking crops like hops and potatoes, working on the roads and fixing pots and pans. But gradually, with intensive farming methods and more automated road building, that work dried up. Also, in post-war Britain, it wasn't unusual to see notices in some accommodations around Britain saying, no Irish, no blacks, no dogs. Times were difficult. This is a song written by Mick Fitzgerald and learnt from the singing of June Tabor about those times. All our trades are gone. Best seat in the house sitting right there. It's so exciting. Aren't these musicians so talented? It's incredible. Now we're going to have another song led by Avital Raz. Avi's music has been described as wise, gleeful, challenging, and melodic. It's also been described as feisty, and possibly even a bit bonkers. Something we in the Passerine wholly approve of. Avri grew up in a religious household in Jerusalem and describes herself as a moral refugee, having been particularly outspoken about the Israeli attitude towards Palestine. The next song was written and first recorded in Tel Aviv and is her farewell to her homeland. This is Bored Lord.
Dear Lord, and I'm bored with your holy men and women dead, Lord, and I'm bored with seeking holiness, Lord, even more with finding loneliness, Lord. Oh, Lord, Lord.
Turning plowshares back to swords, but in your name we'll go invade and kill and hold. The holy wine is poured, and
Avital Raz.
Now a song that has been popular in the Indian subcontinent for centuries and is based on a Sufi poem. It's called Dammast Kalanda, a Kalanda being the name for a type of wandering Sufi holy man or dervish who would often journey through the wilderness wearing tattered clothes. Dammast Kalanda translates to the drunk Kalanda. Anyone drunk in the audience? No, we're too well behaved at Shrewsbury.
Give us another hour.
Yeah. Well, this is going to be a good song to dance to, so I'm going to see some dancing up front here. But in many ways, this song is what brings the whole Passerine project into focus. People from different cultures brought together by music and performance. There are two things to note in this song. Sufi Qawwali music is usually sung by men, but as you can see, inspired by Sarah, there are many women singing on this song. And there is a Shrewsbury festival first, as we experience Belinda, O'Hooley, and Heidi Tidow singing in Punjabi. This is Dammast Kalanda.
Thank you.
Brings us to the end of the first ever performance of the Passerine. We want to thank Shrewsbury Festival for giving us the chance to put this together. And would you also please thank our musicians, Avital Raz, Arian Sadr on percussion, Mina Salama, Sarah Yaseen, Shurooq Elnaas on violin and flute, the wonderful Vijay, Venkat. And of course, our leaders and musical directors, Belinda, O'Hooley and Heidi Tidow. We'd also like to thank Kathy Hart and Abdulaziz Dukan for the use of their images you saw in the show. And, yep. Thanks to Andy Bell on sound and John Leonard, our producer. And of course, Joy Lamont and Sandra and Alan Surtees. Okay.
And give it up for our fabulous narrator, presenter and spoken word artist, Dean Atta.
And together we are the band of migrant songbirds, the Passerine. So, rather than go on and off for an encore, we're gonna do one more song for you. Do you want one more song?
Yes.
This one begins with a verse from Avital in Hebrew, and I'm gonna give you a translation of that. So, once again, from the Passerine, thank you. I don't have another land, even if my land is burning. Only the sound of my mother tongue could permeate my soul.
the ballad of Britain begins tonight.
Wonderful music of the Passerine. Led by Belinda and Heidi, and dancing as well by Hannah. Beautiful music, and they are signing 4 o'clock over at the Roots CD tent, so you can meet them all there and buy a CD. So one more time, the Passerine.